Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala sayyidil anbiya'i wal mursaleen. Wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والذين جاءوا من بعدهم يقولون ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم وقال عز وجل أم يحسدون الناس على ما آتاهم الله من فضله وقال تعالى قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إياكم والحسد فإن الحسد يأكل الحسنات كما تأكل النار الحطب أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم. Among the favors, blessings, and graces of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon this ummah is that He made this ummah integrated, whose people share belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they build their relationship based on their belief in Allah, in the oneness of Allah, and they love each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a characteristic of a Muslim, of a believer, that whenever he sees his Muslim fellow to be enjoying the bounties and mercies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he becomes happy. His heart is happy. And he feels that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most gracious, who is always there to help his poor and needy servants, who are in no comparison with him. He always thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the mercy, for all the blessings, for all the favors he bestowed upon him. And he always make dua to increase more and more in number to all the fellow Muslim brothers and sisters. And on the other hand, this is also a characteristic of a Muslim, a true Muslim. Whenever he sees his Muslim fellow brother or sister in pain, in affliction, in poverty, who is in need, he pities them. And he supplicates to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove this pain, this affliction, or this poverty from their brothers and sisters. His heart is pure. His heart is free from all kind of black envy, hatred, and jealousy. And he knows that black hearts, which are corrupt with envious feelings, are a means to destroy all the good deeds. And he also knows that a heart in which the lie, there lies an envy, the iman cannot live over there. Iman and envy, hatred, cannot stay together. The corrupt hearts, afflicted with black envy, they do away with the good deeds and their merits. And the pure hearts, even if they do small deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them with goodness. And this is also a characteristic of a Muslim brother, to make dua for himself and for all the brothers from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take out these all evil feelings from their hearts. Allah says about these Muslims when they make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِن بَعْدِهِمْ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَلِإِخْوَانِنَا الَّذِينَ سَبَقُونَا بِالْإِيمَانِ وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلًّا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. And those who came after them, they say, O our Lord, forgive us and those who come into faith before us. And leave not in our hearts the rancor against those people who believed. رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. O our Lord, you are full of kindness and the most merciful. This is the characteristic of a Muslim. Islam checks the conditions of the heart every time. In fact, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to seek refuge with him against the envious one. Against the envy and the envious one. The envious person, in fact, is the person who wished that all the favors, all the blessings which have been given to another person should be taken from him, should not exist with him. In fact, the same favors, the same blessings should become his. This envy is a flaming fire in which the envious person burns himself and he also affects the people around him. And as a result, this person becomes an epidemic against whose ill effects the whole society should be warned. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the Sahih Hadith, لا تحاسدوا ولا تباغضوا ولا تدابروا وكونوا عباد الله إخوانا. Do not harbor grudges against each other. Do not envy each other. Do not turn back from each other. And become slaves of Allah and brothers. My dear brothers and sisters, the people are good so long as they do not let this ill feeling in their hearts. If they allow so, then they corrupt their relationship between themselves and they become doomed to loss. Their rest is gone. Their peace of mind and heart is gone. And the troubles overwhelm them. They become sad when they see other brothers are blessed with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it takes away their peace of mind and rest. They do not sleep in night with rest and sleep. Their hearts are being eaten by the grief of hasad, of jealousy, of rancor. Such people are not contented with the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They never satisfy themselves that whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon them, they are not happy with it. They want more and more. They want more of worldly life. And their akhira is destroyed. They will burn on the day of judgment in the fire of hell as they are burning themselves in the fire of jealousy in this worldly life. So my dear brothers and sisters, this is a disease of heart which finds hardly any medicine to cure it. Except we control it. And this feeling is motivated by enmity, by pride, by arrogance, or to show off to people, a disposition to show off. The people of book, when they saw that an illiterate, unschooled person in Quraysh was given the prophethood, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they said, وَقَالُوا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَ هَذَا الْقُرَانُ عَلَىٰ رَجُلٍ مِّنَ الْقَرْيَتَيْنِ عَظِيمٍ. And they said, why was not this Quran revealed to a great person of the two cities? Why this unschooled person? While these people knew, because they had the knowledge, they had the book from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they knew that this is the true prophet, this is the truth. But they wouldn't accept it because of their jealousy, their hatred, their pride and arrogance. And whenever this feeling comes into the heart, it happens among the relatives, among the counterparts, and among the people of the similar characteristics. A tradesman sometimes might envy another person like him, and craftsman might envy with the person who has similar skills, similar crafts. This feeling comes to the people who go for seeking knowledge of Islam. The students of Islam, Islamic knowledge, might envy with each other. Similarly, the scholars of the knowledge might envy with each other because some of them have more effect, more impact upon the people, while the others don't have the same thing. And these people, even if they have the knowledge of Quran, the knowledge of Sunnah Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even then they develop this kind of habit. They harbor ill will against each other because they love this world. They love the prestiges in this world. They love the fame in this world. They love that the people should salute them, should honor them, while they don't want the same thing for others. And in the process, they have a doubt in oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have a doubt in the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are never satisfied with it. And this discontentment, dissatisfaction leads them to destruction. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more than several places in Quran, scolded and told people, mentioned the bad effects, the dangers of this habit, of this feeling in various places of Quran. Allah says that when the people of the book found out that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was given the prophethood, they tried their level best to turn away the Muslims, the believers, as kuffar, as disbelievers after they became Muslims, out of their jealousy. وَدَّ كَثِيرٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ لَوْ يَرُدُّونَكُمْ مِّنْ بَعْدِ إِيمَانِكُمْ كُفَّارًا حَسَدًا مِّنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِهِمْ مِّنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الْحَقِّ. There are the people among the Ahl Kitab who wish to turn you away as disbelievers after you have believed, out of an envy from their own sides, from their own selves, and after it had become, the truth had become manifest upon them. This is the result of jealousy and hatred. And the person who reads the story of Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam and his brothers realizes the danger of envy. And he realizes that how it blinds his sight and how it drives him, how it takes the mercy from his heart, drives him to commit murder, to commit the physical pain upon the person who is being envied. إذ قالوا ليوسف وأخوه أحب إليه من والدي إذ قالوا ليوسف وأخوه أحب إلينا منا ونحن عصبة إن أبانا لفي ضلال مبين. When they say that Yusuf and his brother are more beloved to our father than we, while we are a strong folk, verily our father is in plain error and made a plan. اقتلوا يوسف اطرحوه ارضا يخل لكم وجه ابيكم وتكونوا من بعده قوما صالحين. Kill Joseph or cast him out the other land so that the favors of your father may be given to you and you become among the righteous folk. And how they devised the plan, how they lied to their, deceived their father and took away Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam and cast him in the well. And how they lied to their father. When they made a plan and to reinforce their deceit, they came up with a fake blood over the shirt of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, saying that a wolf ate Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. It was because of jealousy, because of the hatred, rancor, and envy. Similarly, there is another waqiyah in Quran mentioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about the first two sons of Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, Habil and Qabil. وَتُلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ أَبْنِي آدَمَ بِالْحَقِّ إِذْ قَرَّبَا قُرْبَانًا فَتُقُبِّلَ مِنْ أَحَدِهِمَا وَلَمْ يُتَقَبَّلْ مِنَ الْآخَرِ قَالَ لَأَقْتُلَنَّكَ قَالَ إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. And recite unto them the story of the two sons of Adam. When they offered a sacrifice to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sacrifice of the first one of them was accepted, and the sacrifice of the other one was rejected, was not accepted. And when the latter said that my sacrifice was not accepted, I'm going to kill you. Inni laqtulannak, qala laqtulannak. And he said that إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts from those who are pious. And he said, لَإِنْ بَسَطَّ إِلَيَّ يَدَكَ لِتَقْتُلَنِي مَا أَنَا بِبَاسِطٍ يَدِيَ إِلَيْكَ لِيَقْتُلَكَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. He said, you want to kill me? If you stretch your hand against me to kill me, I am not going to stretch my hands against you to kill you. إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Verily I fear Allah, the Lord of the Alameen. فطوعت then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, فطوعت له نفسه قتل أخي فقتله فأصبح من الخاسرين. And the nafs of Qabil, the later one, whose sacrifice was not accepted by Allah, his nafs motivated him and made fair seeming to him the murder for his brother, and he murdered him. And in the process, he became among the losers. Why it happened? And it was the first murder on the face of the earth. It was because of jealousy, hatred. My dear brothers and sisters, this jealousy creeps into our heart without us knowing it, and we practice it. This is a very dangerous disease which destroys all the good deeds which we do to seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to watch it. We need to cure it. We need to work on it. And working on it is not something very easy. We have to be extra careful while realizing it and working on it. Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayh says in his famous book, Ihya Ulumuddin, after mentioning the Inwi and its dangers in many pages, he said that be aware that Inwi is one of the most dangerous diseases of the heart. And there is no medicine to it except with knowledge and deeds. And as to knowledge, how to cure it is the knowledge that one should know without a doubt that envy is dangerous for him in this worldly life and for his deen. While there is no harm, there is no danger for the person who is being envied in his life or in his deen. In fact, quite contrary, the person who is being envied, he gets benefit from it. He gets the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All his sayyat are substituted with hasanat. And this person who is being envious, all his hasanat are become his sayyat, his bad deeds. So this is the knowledge one should know without a doubt. As for the deen, why it becomes harmful for our deen? When you become jealous, then you hate Allah's predestination. You hate Allah's mercy and blessing which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has divided among His servants. And you hate Allah's justice which He has established in His world with a wisdom. You contest it and you reject it. You object to it. And this is against the true sense of oneness, true sense of tawheed and belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And moreover, you share the mission of Iblis and his followers in what? For their love, for the crisis to fall upon the believers. And all the mercy, all the blessings to go away from them. This is the mission of Iblis. So these are the evil thoughts. These are the evil diseases of the hearts which eat up all the good deeds, which erase all the good deeds as the night erases the day. And what are the harm for this worldly life? When we develop this ill feeling in our hearts, it eats up from inside. We become sad. We become sorrowful. Every time we see all our brothers and sisters enjoying the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whenever we see it, we are always in sorrows. We torture ourselves with this ill feeling. This is the harm of this worldly life. And how to counter it? What is the cure? What's the treatment? The medicine of envy is to act upon it, to control it. How to control it? The same process with which the envy had driven you to say something bad about the brothers you envied, you have to say the good thing about him. You have to strive your tongue to compliment him. If the same envy had driven you to take action against the brothers. You have to act in humility and apologize to him. If he had driven you to look down upon him, you have to apologize him. Be humble to him. And if it had driven you to stop from doing good to the brother who used to do good with before you become envious to him, you start doing the same. Push yourself to do again the same thing good to him. Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi said, this medicine is a cure for the heart of this disease of heart. It's very effective, but at the same time it's very bitter upon the hearts. But again, the effectiveness of a medicine lies in its bitterness. If you want to taste the sweetness of cure, you have to be patient with the bitterness of that medicine. It's not going to be easy for you to reverse your nature to the person who you were envious with. You have to work on it. You have to kill your nafs. You have to do quite opposite what your nafs saying, what your disposition is saying, and what the Iblis or his followers are encouraging you to do. Then only you will become true Muslim. And there's a hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in which he said that there are three people whose prayers will not be lifted over their heads, means it will not be accepted from them. Who are these three people? First, the person who leads people in congregational prayer while people hate him. And the second one is the wife who sleeps while her husband is not happy with her. And the third one is the two envious brothers who envy with each other. There is also another hadith in which the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, every Muslim slave who does not associate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiven except for the person who has enmity between him and his brother. It is said, leave these two until they have made reconciliation. My dear brothers, sisters and sisters, all the favors which we enjoy in this worldly life in terms of money, prestige, knowledge, health and good reputation are from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not permissible for any of us to restrict it, to stop it from others. While these are some things which are ordained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and being Muslim, this is a part of our belief that everything is preordained by Allah. Everything comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether it is good or bad. We have to accept it. And this is the true characteristic of a Muslim brother, that whenever he sees his brother to be enjoying good things, he should make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase more. And whenever he sees some brother or sister to be afflicted, to be deprived of any mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or they see them in pain and poverty, they should make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to erase those afflictions from them and forgive them and bless them with mercy and blessings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove every ill feeling, every grudge which we have for our brothers or sisters in Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us ideal Muslims in this worldly life. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us salvation in the world hereafter. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. We have 5 minutes and after that we'll have Jummah khutbah and inshallah salam.